The Caribbean plate moves eastward at about 2 centimeters per year with respect to the North American and South American plates. The boundary between the North American and Caribbean plates in the Greater Antilles is a zone of distributed deformation broken into at least 4 microplates. These microplates accommodate the transition of the North American-Caribbean plate boundary from strike-slip in the Cayman Trough between Cuba and Jamaica to oblique collision between Hispaniola and the Bahama Platform, to oblique subduction at the Puerto Rico Trench, and then to subduction at the Lesser Antilles Trench. The largest of these is the Gonave microplate that stretches from the Cayman Spreading Center to western Hispaniola. In Haiti, the Gonave microplate is bounded on the north by the Septentrional Fault, and on the south by the Enriquillo Fault. Left lateral shear strain across Hispaniola occurs at a rate of 17 millimeters per year. Recent GPS observations document left lateral strike slip rates of 9 millimeters per year on the Septentrional Fault Zone and 11 millimeters per year on the Enriquillo Fault Zone. With only a few decades of seismometer recordings, we must rely on written historical records of earthquakes on these strike slip faults over the past few centuries. A series of earthquakes on the Enriquillo Fault Zone from 1751 to 1770 was followed by the devastating magnitude 7 earthquake on January 12, 2010.